This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to do a linear programming problem, and this is going to be a minimization problem. So the problem says, minimize the objective function z equals 10x plus 20y, subject to the constraints 3x plus 5y is greater than or equal to 1500, x plus 3y is greater than or equal to 600, and x is greater than or equal to 0, and y is greater than or equal to 0. So what they want us to do here is find values for x and y that will make z as small as possible. We're minimizing it. We can't pick just any values. They have to be values that will work with these inequalities. Okay, so what we're going to do is draw a graph for the inequalities. I've got this x is greater than or equal to 0 and y is greater than or equal to 0. That means my graph is only going to be in the first quadrant. Okay, we'll deal with the first inequality. 3x plus 5y is greater than or equal to 1500. I'm going to turn that into an equation. 3x plus 5y equals 1500. And find the x and y intercepts for that equation. So the x-intercept happens along this x-axis where all the y values are 0. So if y was 0, I would just have 3x equals 1500. And therefore, x would equal 500. So I've got an x-intercept at x equals 500. The y-intercept happens along the y-axis where x equals 0. So that would mean my equation would be 5y equals 1500, which means y would equal 300. Okay, I've got the x and the y intercepts. I can connect those lines, those dots. And since the inequality was greater than, I'm going to shade the area above this line. Okay, now let's deal with the second inequality. That one was x plus 3y is greater than or equal to 600. So I'll make that an equation. X plus 3y equals 600. So my y-intercept, that's what happens when my x-intercept, which is what happens when y is 0, is just going to be x equals 600. And my y-intercept will happen when x is 0, so I would have 3y equals 600, which means y would equal 200. I'll connect those two intercepts, and I'll shade the area above that line. And now I've got my feasible region. It's the area above both of the lines where the shading areas overlap. So the next step is going to be to find the corner points. I've got a corner point here on the y-axis that's at 0, 300. I've got another corner point on the x-axis that's at 600, 0. And I want to find this last corner point where the two lines intersect. So let's find what the x and y values are for that. I'll make a little bit of room up here. And what I want to do is take the two inequalities and think of them as equations and solve the system of equations that I get. So I'm going to have 3x plus 5y equals 1500, and then x plus 3y equals 600. I'm going to multiply the second equation by negative 3. That way I can cancel my x's out. So I'll get negative 3x minus 9y equals negative 1800. And I'll add the first equation to that. That's 3x plus 5y equals 1500. I'll add the two equations together. The x's cancel. I get negative 4y equals negative 300. I'm going to divide by negative 4, and I'm going to get y equals 75. Let's put that in here. Okay, now let's go back and plug that 75 in for the y in one of these equations. So I think I'll use the second equation. I'm going to have x plus 3 times 75 equals 600. 3 times 75 is 225. So x plus 225 equals 600. I'll subtract 225 from both sides, and I get x equals 375. So my third corner point is 375, 75. And now what we want to do is find which of those three points, which of those three corners, are going to give us the smallest value for z. So let's rewrite that objective function. That's z equals 10x plus 20y. And I'll make a table where I list the corner points and what z value I get at that point. So I've got a point at 0, 300. X is 0, y is 300. So I've got 10 times 0 is 0, plus 20 times 300 is 6,000. I've got the x-intercept, that's 600, 0. So x is 600, y is 0. I want 10 times x, or 10 times 600, is 6,000. And 20 times 0 is 0. So once again, I get 6,000. Now we'll try that last point at 375, 75. So x is 375, 10 times 375 is 3,750. Y is 75. I want 20 times 75. So let's multiply by 2 and then by 10. 75 times 2 is 150. And then 10 times 150 is 1,500. When I add those together, let's see, I'm going to get 5,250. So the minimal value I can get for z is going to be 5,250, and it's going to happen when x equals 375 and y equals 75. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.